Welcome to Growing with North Carolina Farms, where we talk about people, processes, and plants, because we're here to grow your business.
Well, I'm very excited today to have Natalie. She is the laboratory director at New Blooms Labs. She's been in the testing world and the laboratory world for almost a decade. She was in forensics and toxicology, and now she has taken those skills and applied them into cannabis. And so, Natalie, excited to have you on the podcast today. Really excited to talk to you.
I'm so glad to be here.
What should I be really focusing on as a grower when I pull up a terpene report?
Well, you know, there's a lot of things that you can see or gain from running a terpene profile, and it all just kind of depends on what you want. So just as a quick, you know, nomenclature here, terpene, it's a compound that's produced by the crop. It's in the essential oils of the crop, and it has multiple properties, but the main reason this crop produces it is to attract pollinators, to deviate pests away, just things of that nature. It's just a natural compound that the crop utilizes to help the crop thrive. So it just depends on what you want your product to do for your consumers, really. Terpenes are really starting to take off.
That opens up a whole new kind of angle as a breeder. You know, what are we going to breed for?
Absolutely.
It's one more variable to have to cover, I guess, as you're reading.
For smokable flower, those are going to contain those really concentrated terpenes that the crop has. So yes, these terpenes are what give the crop its aromatic properties. So when you open that jar of beautiful buds that you just trimmed and you get that beautiful smell of the hemp, that's what you're smelling. You're smelling a combination of those terpenes. The more mature the flower is, the more concentrated the terpenes are going to be.
And terpenes are really fragile. They tend to get consumed as you do biomass or whatever. Can you talk me through some of these analytes?
At present, we run 19 of these terpenes. We will add more as time goes on. We are now utilizing mass specs for terpene analysis, which is just absolutely fantastic. So we will have the ability to make this panel a little bit bigger. But currently, we're running 19. We'll begin with citral. So it's kind of citrusy aromatics, lemon oil. It has antimicrobial and immune support properties. We also run beta-caryophyllene as well as caryophyllene oxide, which both kind of have like a clovey, black pepper, cinnamon kind of aromatic to them. And these guys have tons of properties, antimicrobial, anti-inflammatory, antiseptic, antifungal. And those are pretty prominent in a lot of the crops that I see coming through here. We also look at camphene, which is kind of got that fir. It's in fir trees, so it's probably a little piney. Antimicrobial, a good insecticide. Anything that's piney or peppermint or super menthol, eucalyptus, things of that nature are going to be really good insecticides. We also look at carine, which is kind of an earthy, and it's really good at dilating the bronchial tubes. It's good for insomnia. Humulene, alpha humulene, that's the primary terpene in hops. So hops and cannabis actually, they share similar genetics. Alpha humulene, that's a big one we see in cannabis as well. Antimicrobial, anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer, just things, anti-everything for alpha humulene. And it's very abundant in cannabis. Linalool, that's going to be your lavender aromatics. Also good for microbial, anti-anxiety, anti-insomnia, very good smell on that one. That one's also pretty abundant in cannabis. Alpha-terpenine, that's your turpentine sort of aromatics. Terpenylene, that's going to be what you would smell in a lilac. So antimicrobial, anti-insomnia. Limonene, so citrus, lime. Good antimicrobial, also good for dilating the bronchial tubes. So any citrus is also good for that as well. Eucalyptol, that's obviously what you smell in eucalyptus oil. Very good for dilating the bronchial tubes and good anti-inflammatory. Eucalyptus is utilized in a lot of products over the counter. Cinchone, that is what you smell in that awesome fennel vegetable. It's an analgesic, so pain relief and good for insomnia. Not as abundant in cannabis, but you know, we see traces of it every now and then. Alpha pinene, obviously that's what you smell in a pine tree. Also good for dilation of the bronchioles, good for anti-inflammation. Menthol, that's going to be your mint. Again, good dilator of the bronchial tubes, pain relief as well. We actually don't see a lot of menthol in cannabis. Alpha pinene, the one I mentioned before, we see that is super abundant in cannabis. Menthol, we don't see a lot of that in cannabis. It's very rare that I even detect that in cannabis. Sabinine, that's going to be your oaky aromatics. Osamine, that's just going to be a general sort of earthy, herbal kind of aromatic, and that's really good for antifungal. Pulagon, that is another peppermint, so good for dilation of the bronchial tubes, really good insecticide. And gamma terpenine, it's just another aromatic of the turpentine. And borneol. So borneol is anti-insomnia. It's good dilator of the bronchial tubes. It's kind of got a tangy aromatic to it, and it's good for pain relief. We don't see a lot of borneol in cannabis as well. Every now and then we'll see a little bit, but not very abundant in cannabis. And that's the panel. Those are the terpenes that we look for. They're all fascinating and they're all unique.
Well, that is all of that is fascinating. Natalie, would you tell people how they can get up with you if they've got questions about terp profiles or how to get a test? What's the easiest way to reach you?
Well, definitely, you know, the website is going to be the best and easiest way to reach us. If you go to newbloomlabs.com, everything you need is there. There's an 800 number you can call, and you will get straight to a human being on the 800 number. And if you want to speak with me directly, we give that option as well. So that's one thing that New Blooms really has tried to do differently than the rest of the industry is direct line and communication with the laboratory director, with the resident scientist. So call the 800 number. We can make that happen. Additionally, if you need a test, you can go to the website, order a kit. So we offer supply kits and shipping kits. So we take care of the cost of all of that for you. So go on the website, fill out the form, and you will have a shipping kit at your door in a couple of days with everything that you need, from the sample bag or the sample vial, depending on what you're sending, to the order form. Everything that you need is going to be in that box, and you just send it to us. And upon receipt in the laboratory, you should have most of your results, you know, within a business day or two. So we're pretty rapid with that.
Yeah, and I can vouch for these guys. We use them exclusively at this point. If you're standing in front of your crop and you're not sure what to do, give them a call. They'll help you out. And all the COAs come with a QR code. So if you're doing a terp profile for smokable flower, you can take that QR code, put it on your final product, and you have a third party unbiased opinion of what that profile looks like. I'll put all of those links in the show notes for you. Natalie, thank you for your time. I hope you have a great day.
Thanks, Mick. Appreciate it.
We hope you've enjoyed the show today. If you find this content helpful, please let us know. We want to create the content you need. Visit our website at ncfarmsinc.com. Find us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram, or email us at media@ncfarmsinc.com. We're here to grow your business.